So today's discussion is design process, sequential and concurrent engineering. What is the difference between these two? We are going to discuss in this session, and design process in general, the definition part also we are going to discuss. This is just we are refreshing the basic. If you look at the diagram over here, the design process involves the various activities listed in this picture. First one, design modeling, simulation, and animation. Then you have to do the design analysis. You have to fix the dimension of the object. And then design optimization, size and shape you can modify. Either you can increase the dimension or decrease the dimension. Optimization has to be done. Then design evaluation, you have to check whether the object is working in the stated condition or not. That evaluation part you have to do by making prototype or computer simulation also, you can do the evaluation. Then design documentation. After documentation, your idea will be go to shop floor for manufacturing. This is what the conventional design process. If you look at the right, basic structure of CAD system given. This is what your operating system or computer, how does it works? It is connected with input-output devices. User interface, we are giving a program so that it will access the database or CAD model, and you can create the model whatever required. So once the model is built, you can generate CNC code also depending on the capability of the software. So CAD software structure is given in this slide. So user input is given to the computer. What happens? Geometric, it will access the geometric database, and you will be doing addition and modification. Say, if you are building three-dimensional models, you will be making it small entities, and you are going to merge it together so that you can make a complete model. Here, addition, modification referring to Boolean operations, union, subtraction, etc. Okay, so after building your model, geometrical display, you can see the three-dimensional view of the object, or you can generate CNC code if you are going for manufacturing, or you can take a hard copy, or otherwise you can take a print, etc. So software for CAD system, very popular system is AutoCAD, very popular. Still in industry people are using it. Pro Engineer is advanced version of it, exclusively for models. SolidWorks is mechanical design automation software. This is also used for CAD as well as CAM. It has got CNC code generation capability. IDEAS, expansion is integrated design engineering analysis software used for all. It is satisfying CAD, CAM and CAE. Analysis also possible in this software. CATIA, computer aided three-dimensional interactive application, was created by Dassault System. It is a French company. It has got a tremendous capability for intricate shapes. You can generate, modeling is possible, and it has got CNC and NC coding capability also. Okay, so this is what today's discussion dealing with sequential and concurrent design approach. If you look at this picture, so these persons are referring to various departments. So this is department A, department B, department C. All the activities are happening one after other. He has to complete the work. After completion of this, based on his input, this department start working. Next, after completion of his work, this department will be working. So that the work is flowing from left to right sequentially. If any department is not working or some flaw in the process, it will take more time. Second system is centralized design, where every department is reporting to one particular department. Okay, say you can say general manager. So this may be marketing, this may be manufacturing, this may be design, like that. So everybody is communicating with one particular person or one particular department, so that this he may be knowing what is going on at various departments. it is centralized design. Here, concurrent design is communication is possible to a centralized department at the same time inter-department as well. This is also possible. So marketing team is communicating with the design team. Design team is communicating with manufacturing, shop floor. So R&D, likewise, various communication possible. Because of that, while developing a product, then and there correction can be done and project can be, our product can be launched to the market in a very shorter duration. The market is changing so rapidly. In order to cope up with the market, this approach is very much essential. Next, commercial or traditional design process shown in this picture. Here, it's a very conventional model, idea generation. This is very, very important for any business or any industry. Now, I want to post a question. You can give your responses in the chat box. Have you ever thought of idea generating money? If so, you list one or two companies which are running based on ideas only. Give your response in chat box. TCS, good. Okay, let us skip IT company from our discussion. Other than that, you think of some other company. They are all running based on app. Swiggy, very good example. I am expecting actually this kind of answer only. Swiggy is an idea. And you can say Uber is an idea. Ola is an idea. And another interesting thing is that OYO, hotels. OY. Amazon is a portal which connects various products, customer and the product, they are connecting it. Okay, right. So OYO is a very good example. They are not owning not even a single hotel, but they are facilitating and connecting around 4,000 hotels across the globe. They are running a very big business. Okay. So here, idea generation is very important. From where you can generate idea? Number one, marketing. You have to do market survey. Customers will give you feedback. So price is high, or this feature I want, like that. You can get customer viewpoint. R&D department will also give some important input. Supplier will give input. And competitors, their input is very, very important. They will not give you straight away. So we have to do this, that, something like that. Your competitor will be all the time improving their products. And cost-wise also, they will be keeping it very competitive. So depending on that, you have to generate new idea to compete with them. And you have to sustain in the market. Therefore, these are all the various factors by which you can generate new ideas. Okay? Then, feasibility study has to be done. Once idea is generated, you have to study which one is possible for a particular market or which product is possible to manufacture. That feasibility study has to be done. Then next stage, you have to form a design. Once the design is formed, function of the design specification has to be done, and production capability, you have to check it out, whether the particular design is possible to manufacture with the existing facility or not. If there is any slip or some lag, you have to improve the manufacturing facility and go for manufacturing. Once you have done it, you have to do a pilot run. This is a trial run or final testing you have to do. After that, this product will be launched to the market. Once it is launched, again, take feedback. Whoever is using your product, try to incorporate everything in the idea generation stage so that you can improve your product from one level to the other level. Understand? So this is what the linear or traditional approach of making a product. And here, this word, it looks very interesting. What you say, the customers. Some people used to say consumer. What is the difference between taking Colgate from my childhood? Today also I am taking Colgate. I am using Colgate. Okay, I am a consumer to Colgate. Understand? So whatever new product comes into the market, I least bother. I will not go for another choice. Whereas online purchase, this time I may be checking for Amazon, next time I may be looking for some other website which gives competitive price. In this case, buying a product, for buying online purchase, I am a customer. My charge is changing between various service provider. One time I will be buying from Amazon, next time Flipkart, next time some other website, or otherwise I will be visiting my local market and I can buy. In that case, I am a customer, I am not a consumer. Okay, so Balaji has given a very good response, very good answer. Very right. Next one, conventional and concurrent product design. You see this, this is a pictorial representation which shows the distinction between these two approach. Conventional, otherwise it is called a sequential approach, idea generation, product design, manufacturing, assembly, maintenance. So everything is happening step by step. Okay. Whereas here, everything is happening simultaneously. So interdepartmental communication is allowed so that the product improvement is possible then and there. What is the advantage? The lead time to launch a product into the market is very less when compared to the sequential approach. So conventional concurrent engineering approach is preferred. In your life also, concurrent approach is always helpful. I can give you two examples. This is not from your curriculum. It may be your life lesson. Okay, so I can say person A is earning 50,000 rupees per month. Okay, are you hearing me? You give your response in the chat box. 50,000 per month. He is spending all the money. Okay, at the month end, he has got zero. Second year also, he got some increment. Second year also, every month he is drawing and spending like that. So 5 years has gone. After 5 years, his savings or his asset will be zero. Understand? At the same time, I am considering another person, B. He is taking 30,000 per month, and every month he could able to save 5,000, for instance. Okay, so first year he can save 60,000 rupees. At the end of second year, he will be having some 126,000 rupees, 1.26 lakhs he may have, because the initial amount 60,000 plus 10% interest, let us take for simple calculation purpose. So that would be 66 plus another saving 60, he can get 126,000 rupees. So every month it is added up. After 5 years, his saving may be reaching around 4 lakh rupees. Okay. So for case A, first person, his net saving will be zero, though he is earning more. The person B may be having around 4 lakh rupees at the end of 4 years. They are taking a decision. A is buying a car. B is also buying a car. A is buying a car at the cost of 10 lakh rupees by going for a loan. He is also buying 10 lakh rupees car. But in this case, he is going for 6 lakhs rupees as a loan amount. Now, EMI variation may be there. Two cases. The first fellow is using it for his own purpose. The second one is letting it for lease. So in this case, B will be getting every month some income, say around 20,000 rupees addition. Whereas in this case, he is spending on liability, whereas this person always spending on asset. If it continues for another 5 years, what happens? A will remain zero, means every month he is spending everything, but B will be adding up assets. Okay, another 5 years, what happens? The B may not require any job because he will be focusing all his spending on assets. Every month it will generate income. Okay, can you correlate it? So A is working for what? In your opinion, he is working for money. Every time he has to go for job or he has to do business continuously in order to generate the income. Whereas B is making his money to work for him. That is the difference. Okay, he has started at the very earlier stage. After 10-15 years, his assets will generate the required income so that he may not require job at later part. Okay, so he is concurrently designing his financial position, whereas A is not at all focusing on finance. So this is the variation. So whoever be the person, I want every one of you to be like part B, person B, so that certain point of time in your life, you may not require any job or any business. After 10-15 years, hard work is required. You can make your spending on asset so that will generate money. The main difference between A and B is, B is making his money to work for him, whereas in A, working for money. That is the difference. The B is adopting concurrent approach. Okay, so concurrency is always advantageous. Okay, so in this case, if every department is working together, total lead time to launch a product into the market will be very less. Diagrammatic representation between difference between linear and concurrent engineering in these two. Okay, so in timeline, concurrent engineering and sequential engineering. This is also known as conventional engineering. So product definition in sequential engineering requires minimum time, whereas in concurrent engineering it will take larger time because many departments working together, everyone's view is taken care. Design part, it is taking lesser time in sequential engineering, whereas here it is taking more time. Compared to sequential, it is taking more time. All other criterion, verification, redesign, re-verification, etc., will be taking lesser time to sequential engineering. So this much time you can save. From here to here, you can save by going for concurrent engineering. So in concurrent engineering is a strategy where all the tasks involved in product development are done in parallel. Collaboration between all individuals, groups and departments within the company. Various departments are listed: customer research, designers, marketing, accounting, engineering. So why concurrent engineering is required? The market change is very rapid. Okay, therefore we need to launch a product in a faster phase. That is why concurrent engineering is used in the industry. And again, the word change is permanent in the world. Okay, companies must keep pace with changing markets. Decisions made sooner rather than later. Concurrent engineering reduces or eliminates repetition of tasks. Reduces waste and reworking of design. Product quicker to the market. Product launch time is lesser. Maximizes company profit. Company operates more efficiently by adopting concurrent engineering. Okay. So I have all of you could able to see the quiz. What is the difference between the concurrent engineering and the simultaneous engineering? You just give your response in the chat box. So both are same. Concurrent and simultaneous engineering are same. List the benefits of concurrent engineering. Just now I have explained. Maximum profit, quick launch of product, quicker decisions, reduced wastages, minimum rework, etc. CATIA, you can expand it. Computer aided three-dimensional interactive application. Okay.